Today I'm going to be showing you the best tips, tricks, and hidden features of the brand new iPhone 12 Pro, iPhone 12, and iPhone 12 Pro Max. Now this is everything you need to know to become an iPhone 12 expert, so you can use your brand new iPhone running iOS 14 at its absolute peak potential. So let's dive into the best tips, tricks, and hidden features of iPhone 12 running iOS 14. In iOS 14, you can now reply directly to messages in your iMessage app. All you have to do is press and hold on the message, and in addition to the reactions that you're used to getting, you can also click reply. And then what that will do is it'll allow you to reply directly to that message, and so people can see inline responses. So you could say something like, "That's great," and then what it'll do is it'll actually have this be a reply to that original message. Do you ever just want to draw that perfect shape, but you can't seem to get it? Now, a hidden feature right here in iOS 14, this is kind of a fun one, is that you're actually able to draw the perfect shape now. All you have to do is, let's say you're drawing a shape, you know, normally you just draw a circle, it might not turn out that great, but what you can do now is if you draw that circle and then you pause at the end of it and just hold for a second, you can see that it turns automatically into the perfect circle. Now you can do the exact same thing with a star and a variety of other shapes as well. You just need to pause at the end of your drawing and it'll automatically draw that perfect shape. This is a fun one, but a little hidden feature I wanted to add in here as well. iOS 14 now adds the brand new Translate app, which allows you to more easily translate conversations and text instantly into other languages. So you probably already know about this. I'll just give you a quick demo right here. You can now automatically translate with the new Translate app. Just like so. And you can see that it'll automatically translate that into the language of your choice. You can also save specific replies as favorites as well. So let's say you figure out how to say, you know, where is the bathroom, or you have a certain allergy or dietary restriction. That's convenient as well. And then what you can also do is play this back as well.
Vous pouvez désormais traduire automatiquement avec la nouvelle application de traduction.
Now, what you may not know is if you actually go into landscape mode, you can actually take a look at the text a little bit larger just by going into landscape and then clicking the full view, just like that. That way you can get a very easy view that you can show the person you're trying to communicate with. Obviously, you can of course use the voice translation as well, but this is going to allow you to have something that's more visual so you can easily show people when you're looking to translate. Again, all you have to do is just rotate your phone like so, and it'll automatically show up. Now, sometimes it might appear like this. You just have to click the expand icon to automatically have that translation in an expanded view. One other thing you're going to want to explore on your iPhone running iOS 14 is, of course, the app library. If you scroll all the way over on your iPhone, all the way to the right, you can see that we have your app library up here. Now, it'll have suggestions based on apps you visit frequently, but then you can also see recently added apps and different apps that are organized by category, like productivity, social, utilities, entertainment, shopping, information, and more. And it's actually going to create an entire list of the apps that you use most frequently, and it's going to build that all here into your library. Now, of course, you can search the library at any time just by searching at the top, but you can see that it's created all of these different views. And then what you can do is you can go into any of these views, let's say utilities, for instance, and you can take a look at the specific apps that are included inside, just like so. So as you can see down here, we can look at all the different apps that are grouped into each of these smart categories. You can now mirror your selfie camera so that it actually has a true natural view of what you look like instead of using a mirror image. So you can scroll down to the camera application. This is definitely a hidden feature here. Scroll down to the camera application, and then you can see here that you can actually have the ability to mirror front camera, which you can turn on. And what that's going to allow you to do is get a more natural view of what things look like instead of having it be in the mirror image when you're taking a selfie. Let's say you wanted to watch a video in 4K because you want to get all of those vivid colors right here on your iPhone. Let's say you're watching a video on YouTube. I'm just using one as an example. It looks like a pretty cool video here on Costa Rica. All you have to do is tap the icon at the top, right, the more settings, go to quality, And then you can see here that you now have the ability to display videos in complete 4K. So just choose the 4K option. And then when you're playing that video, you can automatically now play it in 4K so you can watch it in the best resolution possible. If you're watching your favorite Apple TV show or show on your iPhone, what you can now do is use this icon right up here at the top to actually just minimize the show so it's in the bottom of your screen. So for instance, let's say you're watching a show like Mythic Quest, which by the way is a great show on Apple TV. You can take this widget and put it down here and actually play the show in the background while you're doing whatever else you want to do. So let's say you're browsing or you happen to be online, whatever it happens to be, maybe you're using a productivity app, but you want to have that show running in the background. You can do that right here with this very simple pop-out widget for your favorite TV show that's playing either on Apple TV or one of your favorite streaming applications. This next hidden feature is a little more serious, and it's not necessarily specific to iOS 14, but I always want to include this because it has the potential to save you from a negative situation. And the way that I see it is even if this just helps one person, then that's worth it. And it's enabling emergency SOS. I encourage all of you to enable this on your phone. So if you go into emergency SOS, what this allows you to do is add call with side button and auto call for emergency services if you get into a negative situation. Now you may already know that if you press and hold on the power and volume up button at the same time, you'll have the ability to power off, get a medical ID, and even access emergency SOS. By swiping that, you'll get access to emergency SOS. Let me just cancel that and type in my passcode. But what you may not know is you can also turn on, if you go into emergency SOS in the settings, call with side button. When you enable that, all you have to do is rapidly press the side button 5 times in order to automatically call emergency services. Make sure you also turn auto call on as well, so it'll automatically call emergency services and notify your emergency contacts that you might be in trouble. Now, hopefully this is something you never have to use. But I wanted to show you this because it's better to install this now and turn this on now so that you have it just in case. So that's emergency SOS, which is a feature that's a little bit hidden. It's not necessarily unique to iOS 14, but it's something I want to show you because even if this just helps one person, then it's worth including it in this video. On iOS 14, you can now customize your home screen to add custom widgets. Check this out. As you can see here, we have the weather widget, and we have a variety of different widgets like our calendar, top news stories, and even a photo album as well, just by swiping through this widget stack. Now, we're going to show you how to add and change the stack in just a second, but you might be wondering, how do you even get these widgets on your home screen in the first place? So what you're going to do is you're just going to press and hold anywhere on the home screen that's not on an app itself. Press and hold, and as you can see, all of the buttons start to jiggle, all the icons, that is. And what you can do is you can go up here to the top left, and you see how you have this new plus icon. You're gonna click that plus icon, and as you can see here, there's all of these different widgets that you can use. Now, we've already selected the weather widget, but let's just say we don't have it. We're just gonna remove it for a second here. So we'll show you exactly how this works. You're gonna go, press and hold, and then you're gonna click the plus button, and you can see right there we have the smart stack, and this includes the weather widget built right in. So as you can see, the smart stack has a variety of different widgets. Now you can choose if you want a small smart stack, or if you want a kind of medium-sized banner style smart stack, or you can even have a full featured smart stack that actually takes up a wide array of your home screen. Now, I opted for the medium and middle size option. I'm clicking add widget here, and it adds it right up at the top. Now, as you can see, it moves all the rest of your apps over and onto the next page. And because this is the smart stack, you can see here that you're actually able to scroll through a wide array of different widgets right here on your home screen. Now, let's say you wanted to change the different widgets that you have right here in that smart stack. All you have to do is press and hold on the smart stack itself, and you can see you can edit weather, which is, you know, the specific widget in the stack, which is the weather app, but you can also edit the whole stack. So if you click edit stack, you can see here that you can add different features to the smart stack, and you can see that we have Siri, weather, calendar, news, and you can actually rotate where you want each of these to be. So if you want photos to come before news, you can rotate it just like that. Now, Smart Rotate also allows you to automatically determine what you're most likely to see. So let's say you check the weather every morning, it's gonna automatically have the weather be the first thing that you see in the Smart Stack. But then later on in the day, let's say you typically go ahead and check your calendar. If that's the case, it will automatically adjust and your iPhone will know and it'll actually show you the calendar as the first thing you see when you look at your Smart Stack in the morning. Now, of course, you can always just scroll through these just by swiping up and down to look at the different widgets in your Smart Stack. Now, you can also add additional widgets to your iPhone as well. You can see here that I've added the clock widget. All you have to do is press and hold on the home screen again and click the little plus icon up at the top, and then you can actually search all of your different apps for different widgets. So you can see we have the fitness, we have the clock, notes, and more. So you can see here that we have a wide variety of different widgets that are come available to us. Let's just say we wanted to add in another clock widget. So we click on clock, and you can see that we can actually swipe between a full clock face that we already have on our phone, a world clock, or even a world clock that's kind of in this, this long horizontal view. So let's just say we want this additional world clock, just click add widget, and you can see that it just adds the widget right there onto your home screen. Now, if you want to move these around at any time, let's say you want to move these down here, you would just move these around like you would a regular application, just like so. As you can see, we can switch where we want each widget to be. And let's say we want to remove a widget, all you have to do is just click the remove icon, just like so. So as you can see, we can move these widgets around, and this is one of the absolute best features that they have in iOS 14. You're gonna wanna do a lot of experimenting with this. Now, let's say that you wanna specifically, you know, change some of these widgets that you have. You can press and hold on a specific widget, and you can see here, you can edit weather. So maybe you wanna change the location. I have my location right there, but you can change that and tap on that. Same thing with the clock. If you press and hold, you can click edit widget, and you can actually change the city. Now, with the different widgets that you have, and obviously all the different apps that you have might have different widgets, you can actually choose and customize those widgets on your home screen just like so. This is absolutely one of the best features in iOS 14. You're really gonna wanna experiment with this. Of course, you have the Smart Stack up here, which I recommend adding right to the top of your home screen. You can, of course, select this and you can edit the stack itself. And what you can do, of course, is add additional widgets. There's a wide array of additional widgets for all kinds of different applications that you may happen to use on your iPhone. So I recommend experimenting, taking a look at them, and looking at the wide array of different widgets that are available to you. So hopefully you found this valuable. And also, let me know in the comments below what your favorite widgets are. I'm constantly looking for new widgets to explore and use, and some of our other AppFind viewers might be interested in that as well. So be sure to let us know down in the comments what your favorite widget is so we can learn from you as well. Now, when you're in the camera application, and let's say you're not in video mode, but you want to quickly take a video, let's say you're taking some pictures and you want to take a video, all you have to do is press and hold the volume up button and you automatically switch to video mode so you can quickly start capturing a video. And then once you release, it stops that video. That's a way to quickly capture a video even when you're in camera mode without having to swipe over to video and then start the video. When you're in the camera app, just simply press and hold on the volume up button and it'll start taking a video automatically. Now in the settings, you can actually change this to have it be a burst series of photos. So you take a variety of photos all at once. You can update that in the settings application as well if you'd prefer. But I like having this enabled so I can quickly take a video when I need to. I hope you're enjoying all of these hidden features, tips and tricks for your iPhone running iOS 14. We have a lot more where these came from, so stick around. We're just gonna show you an incredible app that you can use to earn instant cash back and gift card rewards. We'll be right back after we show you this application. So this next app allows you to earn cash back whenever you shop at grocery stores. It's incredible. You can earn instant cash back just for shopping at your favorite stores. You can also stack this with coupons you might usually use, or just use this on its own to earn cash for shopping. And you'll get a $10 bonus when you use our link, which we're gonna show you exactly how to use. You might as well at least get the bonus. So we're gonna show you how this works. So what you're gonna wanna do is open up your mobile Safari browser, open up a new tab like so, and you're going to go to this exact URL. It is bit.ly/getibotta bonus, just like this. bit.ly/getibotta bonus. You have to put in that exact URL to get that $10 bonus just for signing up and scanning your first receipt to redeem your rebate. So you can click the link right down there in the description. We've also have it up on the screen. It's bit.ly/getibottabonus. That'll make sure that you actually are able to get this bonus. As you can see, Ibotta has over 688,000 ratings, solid 5-star. You can't get better than that. This is an incredible app that helps you save money. As you can see, you can earn real cash. Thousands of retailers across the country you can earn cash back at just for shopping in store. So once we have this Ibotta app downloaded, we can go ahead and open it up. Now you can see here that we have the Ibotta app loading just like so. And as you can see, you can get cash back on everyday purchases. Now, because you used our link, you can actually join and get a $20 welcome bonus. So it usually is $10, but because you used our link, bit.ly/getibottabonus, you can go ahead and get that $20 bonus right there. And then we can go ahead and sign up. So let's go ahead and sign up for the account and show you inside Ibotta. So as you can see, now that we're in the app, you can see just how easy it is to earn cash back. You can see you actually earn cash back on things like Lyft and Uber rides, Best Buy, $10 cash back on limited time deals, 6% at Amazon. You can scroll through here, there's a wide variety, but it also lets you save cash back at different stores as well. You can kind of swipe through here, 75 cents at Uber. I mean, that's easy if you use Uber anyways. Chobani yogurt, $1.22. So let's say you wanted that, you just click on it. You could say here, you could see that you could buy the Chobani, you know, Greek yogurt, pumpkin and spice, which sounds good. Go ahead, click plus, and then you can add that to your cart. And then when you actually go ahead and purchase that item, then what you're gonna be able to do is get that $1.22 back. All you have to do is scan the barcode and the receipt and you'll get that cash back. And remember, just because you used bit.ly/getibottabonus, not only will you get the cash back for whatever you're going shopping at, you're also going to go ahead and get a $20, an elevated $20 bonus just for redeeming that first cashback rebate at any of these stores. You can see there's a wide variety here. Now let's take a look at Walmart for a second here. So let's say you were going into Walmart, you had some things you wanted to get already. They have some of these any brand deals. So you could see any brand of toilet paper, 25 cents back. Any brand of waffles, Pop-Tarts, 50 cents back, right? Hot Pockets, any brand of diapers, any item, just submit a grocery receipt, 10 cents back. These are things that you're going to buy anyways, you have a family, or even you're just shopping for yourself. You can see here that there's a wide variety of different things. Kleenex, $1 back, right? You could scroll through here, Oreos, Bagel Bites, Pancake Mix, Colgate, right? These are name brand items you would have bought anyways that you can go ahead and get cash back for. But here is a great secret. You can go ahead and use that any item grocery store receipt or the any item, you know, toilet paper, whatever you happen to be buying, you can use this any item grocery receipt, scan the receipt for the cash back. You can see this is available not just at Walmart, but Wegmans, Target, a wide variety, Stop and Shop, CVS, right? You can use this in order to get that cash back, but also the $20 bonus for signing up using bit.ly/getibottabonus and then scanning your first receipt and earning your cash back. Now, let's say that you don't have a family, you don't shop as much at grocery stores, you can even do this at convenience stores like 7-Eleven, Kmart, you know, CVS. So let's say we wanted to search for CVS. So we search up here for CVS like so. See that we have CVS. We click on CVS in store, and you can even get this for things like gum, a variety of different things at CVS. I'd have to scroll through and find them, but there's a wide variety of different cashback options that you can get. So you don't have to go grocery shopping to do this, but obviously that's an easy way to get that. So you can get instant cashback and a $20 bonus by going to bit.ly/getibottabonus, link down there in the description and on the screen, and just redeem your first cashback rebate. Enjoy. These next couple hidden features pertain to the app library, where of course you have all of the variety of different applications that are available to you. It's right here at the end of your phone if you swipe all the way to the right. And so what this is you actually have a couple customizations that you can do. So if you scroll down to the home screen, you can see here that you can have newly downloaded apps. Maybe you don't want them to be on the home screen, you just want to add them to the library. You can change this to app library only, And if you want, you can actually turn on notification badges in the app library, but be careful if you're like me and you have hundreds and hundreds of messages and emails coming in all the time. You might want to keep the app library a little bit uncluttered with those badge icons, but again, of course, it's up to you. These hidden features are right here in the home screen settings of your settings application, and that will allow you to change the different settings for your app library. This next one's really quick, but if you actually swipe down and you start to search an application, Siri will actually have a suggestion of what it thinks you're about to type in. So for instance, because I go on YouTube a lot, you can see that this is pre-selected. It has that little halo around it. You can see it has that little white box, drop shadow around it. All you have to do is click go and it'll automatically open that top suggestion. So if you type this, if you start typing something in Siri thinks that that's what you're actually going to go to. Like with settings, you can see that's the top suggestion. Just click go and it'll automatically open it instead of having to, you know, move your hand all the way up over there and actually, you know, tap it manually yourself.
You can now enhance your recordings to get rid of background noise, things like that, that might be going on in the background like that, just by using...
So what you can do is you can enhance these recordings just by using this new wand icon to edit your recordings. Watch this. We can clean up how this recording sounds. This one wasn't actually that bad, but imagine you're out and about, you're in a busy street or area. You want to make sure that you have this recording and it doesn't have so much background noise. All you have to do is press this little button right here at the top left, and it'll automatically clean up that audio for you. Watch this.
You can now enhance your recordings to get rid of background noise, things like that, that might be going on in the background, like that.
See how it got rid of that area, and it's just by using that feature right there to enhance your recordings. Now, this one wasn't actually that bad to begin with, but you'll notice a much stronger change if you have an audio recording that has a lot of wind or noise in the background. You can use that automatic enhance, similar to the automatic enhance that you can do on a photo that you take on your iPhone. I want to invite you to sign up for AppFind VIP, where we're sending the best mobile apps and games directly to your email inbox. All you have to do is go to appfindvip.com. It's right here on the screen and in the description. And what we're doing is we're consistently sending the best mobile apps and games directly to your email, and you'll automatically be entered to win iTunes gift cards, Google Play gift cards, and all of our giveaways that we have exclusively for AppFind VIP subscribers. Now, this is completely free, and we're sending out the best mobile apps and games. Let's say you only want to receive the best apps. You don't have to choose the games feature, or if you just want to receive the best games, you can choose what subscription works best for you, but of course it's completely free. So just put in your name, email address, and of course choose the emails you want to receive. And of course I recommend receiving the giveaways, because we're constantly giving out iTunes gift cards, Amazon gift cards, Google Play gift cards, just for being an email newsletter subscriber. So you can automatically enter to win those giveaways. So go to appfindvip.com. We'll send the best mobile apps and games directly to your email inbox. That way you never miss an incredible new mobile app or mobile game, and you're automatically entered to win our gift card giveaways. Go to appfindvip.com, and I'm looking forward to seeing you there. So it's not just your home screen that allows you to add widgets in iOS 14. If you scroll over, you can also add widgets to your search page as well. Now, obviously, I've actually added a couple in here already. I had the news in there, and I also added my battery widget, because I don't really want to have that on my home screen, but this is perfect for my search screen over here. So what I can do is I can press and hold, and I can add in new widgets just by, again, pressing the plus icon at the top. And as you can see, I can search here. So let's say I wanted to add in one of the clock widgets, just like so. I could choose a big one, or let's say I wanted to include the world clock. I can add that right here, and it slots right in perfectly into my screen over here as well. Now, let's say I wanted to add another widget, I can click plus. Let's say I wanted to find a weather widget, and instead of having the small one or the medium-sized widget, I want the largest one possible. So let's go ahead and add that in. And so now whenever I scroll over, I can actually see a complete view of the weather. Now, let's say I wanted to move that up. I could just swipe to move that up here, and I can just go over these other ones just like so. And you can also stack a couple widgets on top of each other. So I actually just did that by accident. You can see that I added these two, the screen time widget along with the weather widget as well. But I can move that around, and as you can see, it was just a little bit difficult to get it over this news one because it's a pretty big widget there. But as you can see now, if I scroll over from my home screen, you can see that I have access to my calendar, my battery, and then also a full view of the weather. So I can have a small view of the weather over here, and then a full view when I swipe over. I've got a list of the news, and then I can, of course, also swipe through this smart stack to also see my screen time. So that's another thing you can do as well. If you want to drag one widget on top of another, and that's something we're actually going to show you, you can actually create a smart stack so you can scroll through them. That's also similar to the smart stack that we showed you how to build on your home screen. So you can do that by dragging widgets right on top of each other to create that smart stack. Now, I recommend adding in a variety of these different widgets over here and really customizing it to make it your own. Not just on the home screen, on your different screens, but also over here as well, so you can get a better, more expanded view. A new feature in iOS 14 is you can actually hide pages. So let's say you have a variety of pages, but you don't necessarily want to have all of them there at once. All you have to do is press and hold, and then actually click on the pages icon down here, like so, click here, and you can see all of the different pages you have available to you. Now, what you can decide to do is, let's say you want to hide a couple of these. You see here I have a bunch of, you know, folders filled with a lot of different apps. These are usually apps that I review, but maybe don't use every day. So what I can do is I can deselect these, and so now these pages are hidden. I can, of course, always go back and re-enable them later, but now I actually don't have those pages of apps anymore. It skips past those, and that way I can more easily and quickly get to the app library. If I ever want to add those again, all I have to do is, again, press and hold, go to the pages, and just re-enable the pages down here, and then they'll appear again for me when I click done, and you can see there I have my pages available to me again. That's a nice hidden feature that you can enable right here in iOS 14. I hope you found this video valuable on the best hidden features, tips, and tricks for your iPhone 12, 12 Pro, or 12 Pro Max. Let us know what your favorite hidden features are in the comment section below. Be sure to like the video if you found it valuable and share it with your friends so they can see the best hidden features as well. Now, don't forget to take a look at the apps we talked about down there in the description below. Those help to support the show, and you can earn gift cards and rewards just by taking simple surveys and completing some tasks. And be sure to subscribe so you can get more iPhone 12, 12 Pro, 12 Pro Max, and iOS 14 content right here on AppFind. We're constantly posting new videos. We also have a video coming soon on the best iPhone 12 apps that you're not gonna wanna miss. So be sure to subscribe so you can stay up to date with all the latest content. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video and have a great day.